presented in this article is some interesting, humorous, but very effective marriage advice for women. So all you married or soon-to-be married ladies, read on. Women are way better in terms of understanding the needs and wants of their men, rather than the other way round. However, there are still some missing blanks, which, if a woman is able to fill, can ensure a wonderfully happy and long-lasting wedded life with her husband. The following humorous pieces of advice are nothing but those missing blanks, in addition to a bit of inside information. Marriage advice for the ladies. Number 1. Space. Give your man his space. Most women have heard about this, many have even understood it, but very few actually implement it. A man's mind is a mysterious maze. At times, it does not rely on logic, but on instinct, gut feeling, or his mood. At times, it is best to just let him be. Let him do his own thing and he'll be the happiest bloke in town, which in return, is good for you too. Number 2. If you go shopping with your man and you catch him glancing at another hot woman across the street, let me tell you, it is completely normal. 101 out of 100 guys have a wandering eye. I mean, we're born with it. It's in our blood. However, it does not mean that we're having an affair or that we're cheating. Do not confuse a wandering eye as a sign of infidelity. So basically, your guy chucking out another woman right arrow perfectly normal. Your guy chucking out another man right arrow now, you've got some worries. Number 3. If his old schoolmates phone to inform about a last-minute football match, on the same day that you both had plans to redo the kitchen. Take a deep breath, count to 5, give him a sweet smile, even if it is fake, and allow him to go. Believe me, gestures like these really count and they do help in strengthening the bond between husband and wife. Number 4. Man and machine have a relation of their own, and one which is rarely interpreted or understood by women. Men are freakishly obsessed with their cars, home theater systems, and other similar electronic gadgets and gizmos. These things constitute a man's territory and trespassers are not generally welcomed with open arms. Number 5. To all women who are of the opinion that men are heartless creatures made of stone, let me tell you, that's not quite the case. Men are like coconuts. We may appear to be all stony, grumpy, and hard on the outside, but there is a softy inside each one of us. How well or cleverly a woman identifies her man's soft spot and uses it to her advantage, often determines how strong their bond is, how live their romance is, and how smooth their relationship remains. Number 6. The best way, and believe me, it is the quickest, of bringing life back into a seemingly dull marriage is through sex. Nothing works better. It is your trump card, your master key, a small spark which instantly grows into a raging fireball. Believe me, ladies, the best way to get to a man's heart is not through his belly, but through the bedroom. Number 7. Newlywed women, please note the following point. One thing that a woman must avoid at all costs is backseat driving. Men are capable drivers, and to be frank, much better too. Backseat driving is a strict no. It annoys us like crazy. Oh, and since we're on this subject, here's another point. When driving to an unknown destination and along an unfamiliar route, if he finds himself in unfamiliar territory, your man will wait nearly until eternity before he admits that he's lost. It's a guy thing. There's no logic to it, I completely agree, but that's what it is. It happens. So, the best thing you can do in such a situation is, let him figure out things for himself. Pitch in with your suggestions or solutions only after he has exhausted his. To you it may sound like a completely absurd thing to do, but you should do it. It's just one of those things which have no explanation. Number 8. Ladies, boost your man's ego from time to time and make him feel good about himself. It's a guy thing, once again, there's no real logic to it. Praise him for a job well done, even if it is as silly or simple as fitting a light bulb, or changing your baby's diaper. Making a man feel good about himself will boomerang back into benefits for yourself. Number 9. Finally, Accept your man and love him for what he is. He may forget your birthday, buy the wrong variety of dishwashing detergent, absent-mindedly get you a bunch of beautiful fresh flowers which you're unfortunately allergic to, and embark on a rare mission of cleaning the house, which only results in him leaving it in a bigger mess than what it was originally. But don't forget, at the same time, he's also the one who will cover you with his jacket during a chilly midnight walk, try his hand at hilariously silly poetry just because he knows you like poems, and patiently put up with all your mood swings and cravings during that time of the month. Yes, men are goofy, but in quite a lovable way. Love him wholeheartedly and show him that you do, and he'll be yours to cherish for a lifetime of wedded bliss. Number 10. Last but definitely not the least, smile. Nothing makes a woman more beautiful than her lovely smile does. Women rarely understand the immense power of their beautiful smiles. It can make the roughest and toughest of men go weak in the knees. It can tame a lion of a man into something you want to cuddle up against. A flash of that smile can melt his heart, keep you close, and never apart. That was my line, by the way. So ladies, smile more. We simply love it when you do. Use the tips given above and have your husband completely besotted with you. A marriage, whether old or new, needs to be worked on. So, keep that spark alive and love him unconditionally.